I'm at this beautiful, newly renovated A-frame cabin about 2 hours outside of New York City today. This place has 4 bedrooms, this really gorgeous main room or great room with the gigantic windows. But what I think is definitely different about this place and quite unique is it's very geared towards remote work. There's actually a bunch of extra computer monitors in some of the bedrooms. I've never seen that before at an Airbnb. There's also just tons of charging cables everywhere and really strong Wi-Fi. So if you just need a change of pace from your home office or whatever your current work setup is, I highly suggest checking out this A-frame. Let's go and start the tour. Welcome to this gorgeous luxury A-frame cabin. It has been dubbed the Upstate A-frame by the owners. Coming in at about 2,000 square feet of living space, it was initially built in 1968 and has now been recently renovated. I loved the front of this home though, in particular the wood finishing on the bottom floor. And if we turn the lights on, you can get a little peek inside. In my opinion, the more windows on an A-frame, the better, and these owners certainly took that to heart. We are now in the backyard and I'm going to walk up this long path towards the back of the property because there is a nice fire pit set up. You have some wood already waiting for you and I just think you can never go wrong with a fire at a cabin these days. But that's it for everything outside, so I'm gonna run up the stairs now, open up the front door, and it is now time to finally go and check out the interior. Welcome inside. This is what I would probably call the entry hall. There are a bunch of doors around us that connect us to a ton of bedrooms and bathrooms. Starting first over here, I love the shape of that mirror and the brown color scheme. If we now go to the other side of this room and we pull back these two white doors, you have a washer and dryer units, which is definitely a nice amenity. We're now going to walk into the first of 3 bedrooms in this A-frame. There's also a sleeping loft, which we are going to see later, but this is one of the more spacious bedrooms in this cabin. You have your bed, of course, in the middle with dressers on both sides for storage. If you now walk a little further in, you have your desk and work from home setup. I spent 3 nights at this cabin and I got a ton of editing done. Having a second computer monitor is a true luxury. We are now back in the entry hall and we have these 3 doors. We're going to walk through the door on the far left and this will take us into the 2nd bedroom. It's a little smaller than the last bedroom we just came from, but you have your mattress in this corner and another desk and work from home setup in the other. In addition, you have that comfy leather desk chair, and in the final corner, you have this big bag, which is filled with 3 exercise or yoga mats that you can use for a workout during your stay. Moving along, the door on the far right contains the 1st bathroom we'll see on this tour. There are 2.5 baths total throughout this A-frame. This is the largest. On the right side, you have your sink area and some beautiful modern artwork. Along the opposite end, you then have your bathtub, and you may see this little countertop on the right side. You have a bunch of decorations and plants. None of this stuff was mine, it was all there, and you have some great high quality stuff like Moroccan shampoo and conditioner and bath salts. The 3rd and final door on this floor will take us into the master bedroom. Definitely the most spacious of the bedrooms, and it has that gigantic king-size mattress. I love the details as well, like the headboard and the lighting fixture. And in this far corner, you have some more shelf space. Next, along this wall, you have a large dresser and a nice mirror. And last but not least, there are decorations all throughout, the most notable being this one with some plants and rope. To finish off the master bedroom, we're gonna walk to this corner and open up this door, and this will lead us into your in-suite bathroom. There's definitely a few similarities to the last bathroom we were just in, most notably this beautiful sink setup in the corner, but if we turn our attention to the shower, you have this gorgeous blue tile throughout and the golden accents on the shower head. Finally, you have your toilet and some more shelf space in this corner. That's it for this bottom floor, so we're now gonna walk up this cool staircase and head into my favorite space in the interior. Welcome to the beautiful main living room area. I especially love those white beams you'll see as we pan up. And if you look across the way, you will see your comfy couch and lounge area. If we get a bit closer, you'll see a huge plant on your left, and there's enough seating for about four people on your couch. Also waiting for you, there are a bunch of cabin books, most notably the modern A-frame and the book Hide and Seek. The coffee table looks like a piece of art in itself. I was also sitting on the couch and later found this iPhone charging cable from the host, which is super helpful. Last but not least, over on this right side, you have two comfortable footstools and a nice lounge chair, which is perfect for curling up with a book. Continuing on in this main room, if we go over here, you have this huge TV. It has to be at least 50 or 60 inches wide, I think. And it is a smart TV, so you can use all of your normal streaming services during your stay. We'll quickly pop outside by opening up these big sliding doors, and this will take us to our main outdoor deck, and it gives you a nice view of the front yard. This gives you some perspective from the drone. And if we now look on the left-hand side, you have a little outdoor dining table with two chairs and two more additional seating options on the other side. That's it for everything in this main room, so I'll now walk further back into the cabin, which will take you to your dining room. The highlight is this huge, beautiful table with enough seating for six people around it. Also, waiting for you on top of the table if you stay here is a nice bottle of wine and a handwritten note. Moving further in, we'll now enter into your fully equipped kitchen. As we pan, you'll see some of your appliances like the dishwasher over on the right side. You also have your oven, a stovetop, your coffee maker, and your microwave over here. And on the opposite end, you have items like your sink and toaster oven and more shelf space up top. Next up, you have this lovely cocktail cart. I don't see too many of these in Airbnbs. It even has some cocktail supplies and some nice glasses. Me personally, I much prefer cocktails over beer or wine, so I definitely appreciated this. If we head through this door right next to the cocktail cart, this will actually take us into a half bathroom. It's very convenient, so you don't have to go downstairs. I love the modern wallpaper, and all the tiling along the floor caught my eye. To get to the final room in this A-frame, we're going to walk up this spiral staircase, which leads us into the sleeping loft. You have a queen-size mattress up here, also a unique design with the windows along that far wall. If we now walk over here and look over this edge, this gives you a cool view looking back down into the great room. I mean, just look at all of the wood finishing, the white beams, and those A-frame windows. Thanks for watching, guys. My A-frame playlist is linked in the video description, and I'll see you very soon for another Airbnb tour.